The two words that turn self-sabotage into success. Whether it's procrastination, a fear of rejection, perfectionism, or feelings of unworthiness, we all have ingrained, and often subconscious, ways that we may sabotage our self-interests. This self-defense mechanism gone haywire seemingly protects us from disappointment. If we never try, we can't fail, but it also blinds us to our true potential. Underlying all of it is fear, fear of change, of the unknown, of failure, and even of success. Self-sabotage trap number one, procrastination and fear of rejection. When your sabotaging instinct convinces you that it's safer to remain in your comfort zone, tap the power of a proven strategy called opposite action, advises SETI. The best way to change a pattern of behavior is to do the exact opposite of what self-sabotage tells you. The effectiveness of this technique lies in its simplicity because it requires just one step, preventing you from overthinking and falling further into a hole of inaction. Self-sabotage trap number two, perfectionism. Perfectionism sabotages our success because it tells us that we can't let ourselves ask for help. That would somehow make us weak, says neuropsychologist Judy Ho, PhD, author of Stop Self-Sabotage. 6 steps to unlock your true motivation, harness your willpower, and get out of your own way. Perfectionists want to take on everything themselves, but letting yourself be a little vulnerable by reminding yourself that you can ask for assistance will not only allay stress, it'll also bring you closer to others. To foster a more self-compassionate mindset, she suggests telling yourself, "If I achieve even close to 80% of my goal, I'm doing better than most people." Remind yourself that perfect isn't real, effort is. Self-sabotage trap number three, generalization. Often when we're struggling in one aspect of our lives, we start to generalize and falsely believe we're failing in everything we do. One of my favorite techniques is simply to say the two words, yes, but. In the end, speaking to yourself as kindly as you would to a friend is the key to getting out of your own way and embracing the bright, hope-filled future you deserve.